Jacksepticeye, forgive me. I'm about to steal your intro. Top of the morning to you, laddies. My name is Matthew of Karsik from Of Karsik Films, and welcome back to Outlast. Happy St. Patty's Day to y'all. Wearing my green? He's not. By the way, who is this? You might be asking. This is my buddy Jared. He's going to sit in on our Let's Play today. He's never seen Outlast. You haven't seen Outlast, right?
Nope.
He's never seen Outlast. He doesn't know what it's about. We'll catch him up as we go, but he's a giant scaredy cat. So, you ready?
I'm ready.
All right. I don't have a good setup just yet, he's going to hold the microphone as close to us as we can, because that's the only way you're going to hear us. But I'm all set for this Let's Play. This is going to be a very special St. Patrick's Day Let's Play. It's going to be an hour long. I'm wearing my green, and I've got my beer, which is also green. I can't say the name because that's product placement, and I'm not making money off them, so why am I? You'll probably see it if you zoom in real close. All right, I'm handing the mic off.
All right. We have to get close together.
So basically what it is the first game you're an investigative reporter in an insane asylum, and you have to go through this insane asylum and record everything, take notes, and in this one, you worked for the insane asylum, but you tried to spill secrets, and now you're in trouble, and you're in the asylum, and you're trying to get out. All good stuff.
Shit my pants.
I have the volume turned up really loud. He's already breathing heavy. Cannibal with a hacksaw trying to get us. Where is he? He sees me. I don't know where he is. He's over there.
There you go.
Oh, he's running. Are you okay?
Yeah.
You're not gonna have a heart attack on me now, are you?
I might.
Oh. Oh yeah, that's great. You'll like a couple characters in the game. They're called the Penis Twins. Fully naked, buff guys, and their dicks are way out there. This sucks. I can't say anything with or without night vision.
I'm glad I peed before we started this. I
have no idea what just hit me. I heard running, and before I could react, we got hit. I'm nowhere near you! Step off me, bro.
Lock.
Ah! No? I'm gonna follow you guys. Okay, no. You know what? It's fine. I don't need to. You just.
Did they attack you?
Some of them do. Some of them don't care about you, and some of them are like, really like, you're gonna attack you. I don't know where I'm going. Hey, look, stairs. It's a good stairs. No. Alright, saving, so we're doing some right. Okay. Hey, what do you want? Shut the door. Not with me outside! Here we go. What's in here? Cool battery. I could use that. Nothing. I would've... Alright. Well, he appears to have gone. And that appears to be locked. But it's saved. For some reason. So there's gonna be something... Well, there's a ladder. Hey, there's a guy. Oh, he's playing some basketball.
So what is the basketball that it's like?
Oh, is that a head?
That is not that picture.
This is what the game is. Alright. These, were just your typical asylum type people. Not necessarily very dangerous, but they went through a morphogenic engine that made them all deformed and even more dangerous.
Kind of like, Tales of Eyes.
Yeah. He's playing alone and losing. That is what the game is. There's a mathematical proof. If you add 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 and so on up to infinity, you can arrive at an answer. If you stop shy of... My goodness. If you stop shy of infinity, you have an what? You have a large number. If you continue all the way to infinity, you arrive at 1/12, -0.0833333, repeating. I'm losing my grip on things. I'm thinking about the drive here. 400 miles in a rented truck. The job that shows up in time to cover our bills, our debts, the insurance. The boys sleeping in the back. Nothing but AM radio. Gospel, country, western, late night, paranoiac? Talk radio. We sang Patsy Cline? Clean? Songs and laughed at conspiracies of aliens and ghosts. Mile marker numbers passing. What? Is he telling us here? Alright. Oh, God. Arr. Who said that? What?
Oh, God, I hear footsteps.
I do too. I think someone just ran down there. Oh, dude.
Yum. That's what I want for Dendon.
Alright, a dead end. Great. Love it. Maybe? Yep. Do I need to go this way? Is this a thing? It's not a thing. I
shrubbery.
I think this is where I came from. What the fuck? Hey! Where am I supposed to go?
Jesus Christ.
He looks nervous.
I would like to kill him.
As would I.
Thank you.
not a fart.
I'm sorry. Hey!
Ah! Go, 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 go,
got another one, and excuse me, and I'm not sure you're gonna be able to check it off as psychotic proximity disorder, security guard, blah, blah, blah. Guys, I really don't want to read this. Do you want to read it?
No, not really.
All right, just pause it if you want to read it.
It's really long.
It is really long. Okay.
I'm blind, so without my glasses, I can't read that anyway.
So right now. So right now we're looking for the tower that has a radio in it so we can call for help.
No! Why did he attack us?
I don't know. Useless room. Is this locked? All the better.
Don't trust them. They'll tell you it's science, but it's not. They were waiting for us in this place. Billy understood. They've always been here.
See, there's some guys like that that just talk to you. They're actually, some of them are really nice. Good guys.
No.
We're just gonna shut that.
Oh no. We have to go that way.
Yep.
Might not see us.
Don't be afraid, you're doing his work, whether you know it or not.
He's saying down the drain. This is Father Martin. He's part of the main game. So what it is that the two playable characters, right now we're playing Wayland Park, the other character, Miles, they're in here at the same time. They just never run into each other. And in the game, you come across this wall, but it's already saying don't down the drain. So Miles is gonna show up here somewhere. It's cool how it correlates with each other. So we rose down. Somebody who looks as much like a priest as this place looks like an asylum, writing instructions on the wall, talking about God, tells me not to be afraid. How was I ever a part of this inhuman bullshit greed-driven moral genocide? The monsters Murkoff ripped from tortured minds. The lengths their jackboot business school worms will go to protect it. Their own men slaughtered. I've never prayed in my life, Lisa, but if some small-minded interventionist God is listening, kill Jeremy Blair before I die. Sanity and...
I don't even know what that word is.
I don't know. There is no pain he doesn't deserve. There is no radio, no hope of reaching the outside world, only escape. Jeremy Blair is the guy who attacked us at the radio. He's responsible for all this bullshit.
No more nightmares! No more nightmares! I'm not the sick one! You lying motherfuckers! Fuck you! Come here! No more sickness! No more nightmares!
Get out of my room!
Oh God! One of them's coming! It's not even human anymore! Block it! Shut it in!
Thank you.
Like another half hour.
Hell yeah.
And then we're gonna do more!
Hell yeah. Uh-oh.
You can't follow us outside.
That's too damn bad. Fast the batteries die in this game.
The power's still on? Electricity? I need to think, Lisa. I thought the power was evidence that some manageable, some human force still controls some part of Mount Massive. But nothing human or sane can do anything here but survive. And even that, not for long. You're always the reasonable one, Lisa. You would tell me to calm down, to take a larger view. Madness and humanity rule this place. Whatever is keeping the electricity flowing is trying to trap me here. I need to shut it down.
I'm a rabbit hole we go.
So easy. I don't believe it anymore. Getting the truth out. There is no truth, only lies. We've accepted too long to double back on. It's our own children, Lisa. By the way, Lisa's his wife. He's writing these notes to his wife. I would take the easy way out if it wasn't for the boys. Damn this place to hell. I suffer anything to get out of it.
Oh, you're suffering, all right.
So
same. Now it's gone.
Could have been worse.
Yeah, he could have, like, you know, lifted himself up or something. What video game watchers?
Maybe some girls that need blood.
You ain't old enough to be worrying about it. We have worse problems. Grow some hair on your peck or two. There. He'll hurt us.
He'll hurt you. You make a pretty woman.
No sense in pulling a mad dog's tail.
We feed him a goat and leave him alone.
Inside, like, the harder I try to escape, the deeper I get. Dead men aren't a surprise anymore. Suicide seems wise.
Damn straight, I would just, like, if I was in this situation, hell not. Or I'd have a heart attack. I'd probably have a heart attack.
Quiet!
No, don't do that to me!
If they catch us, you give us to him. The man downstairs, the man, very bad, very, very bad. God, oh God.
Why'd you run away? Come back.
Ah! Kill the rats! He's here, inside the walls! Kill him!
Dr. Ford, I conducted another interview with your patient Dennis this afternoon, and we have to agree with your suspicions. In the course of a 40-minute interview, I had wide exposure to all four of Dennis's expressed personalities. As near as I could tell, two brothers, their father, and their grandfather, they seem primarily concerned with some sort of life-threatening flood, though there was little consistency between this event having already happened or threatening imminent arrival. Guys, if you want to read the rest of that, pause it now, real quick, and then I'll go to the next page. So go ahead and pause.
Did you want?
Okay, next page. Pause. Oh, really? Really? You couldn't fit that right there in the bottom. You couldn't. Oh my God, fucking A. Still got 20 minutes, and then some. Shit, where am I going? What am I doing with my life? Oh God. Oh
there's a leak hissing down.
There he is! What do you think?
Oh, he'll do.
For once, we agree.
No!
You don't have to know anymore. You could make that hole.
I can feel that emptiness inside
me. I bet you could, big boy. I'm screaming.
Did I frighten you? I'm awfully sorry, I didn't mean to. We've met before, haven't we? I know, I've seen your face. Maybe just before I woke up. Although it seems like a dream now, being here with you. Let me see you. You don't have to be alone anymore. You could make me
cut on my butthole, Daddy.
I can feel that emptiness inside you.
Don't look down here. Go away. I wish we could like punch him or something. Like jump up.
Bitch!
Daddy, go away. You scare me.
Say go away, Daddy.
Run. really can I find? Who she like the little girl that I have?
Sorry, Daddy.
Darling, can't hide from me. You make yourself a gift for me. A delicacy to be unwrapped and unwrapped again and savored.
You're fucked.
Here we go.
Daddy, what are you doing? Stop it. Stop it, Daddy.
I've been a little vulgar, and I want to say I'm sorry. I just, you know how a man gets what he wants to know. But after the ceremony, I've made an honest woman of you. I promise I'll be a different man.
Just so you all know, Jared's like uber gay.
A legacy to be the father I never had. I'll never let anything happen to our children. Not like.
Not like what? You didn't finish!
I know you must be just as eager as I am to consummate our love. But try to enjoy it.
Super fucking kinky.
Darling. This will help you.
This is the first. Twelve hours later. He's got no panties on.
Maybe ask
some people. Darling, I need you to try to bleed less. I know the fair sex often endures the same wounds with your suffering, but you really need to make an effort.
Ooh, right in the bunghole.
No, I'm so sorry, darling. Love isn't for everybody.
Oh no.
This game is fucked.
Hold still now, darling. All these unsightly hairs. Oh, silky smooth, like a little girl again. Now the worn, delicate bits.
Is it actually a female or is it a male?
No! No, don't! Please!
Oh! Ouchie.
Oh, God! Just give it up. You're ugly. Just give it up. Oh. You're not even worse. Oh God! Please.
Ah! Oh my God! This game is so violent.
You have amazing bone structure. Such soft skin. You're going to be beautiful. A woman has to suffer some things. It's not pleasant, I know. But just try to endure. For my sake. For the sake of our children. It won't take long. A few snips of the flesh here and here. Cut away everything vulgar. A soft place to welcome my seed. To grow our family. The incision will hurt. And the conception. And birthing is never easy. I'm gonna make it happen. Just hold on.
Get back here!